Hey guys, Tyler here. More recently on social media, I saw a video that was talking about Venezuela, and there were various elements within the video that I personally disagree with. In this video, I'm going to respond to the stuff that I found to be questionable, and hopefully you guys will understand my point of view on why I thought it was questionable when I saw the video at first glance.
Just like that, Venezuela's got a new president. Was he elected? Nope. But after swearing himself in, Juan Guaido was recognized as the legit president of Venezuela by Trump, Canada, and a bunch of right-wing Latin American countries allied with the US. Apparently, appointing yourself president is all it takes. But for real, what's happening in Venezuela is a straight-up coup against that country's democratically elected leader, Nicolas Maduro. And it's creating the dangerous conditions for a civil war, with several people already reported dead.
There were so much lies and misinformation within seconds of that clip that I need to address. For starters, Nicolas Maduro was not democratically elected in Venezuela. Here's a quotation from an article from the New York Times. Venezuela reported false election turnout, voting company says. Bogota, Colombia. The Venezuelan government reported false turnout figures for its contentious election over the weekend, announcing a tally that has been altered by at least 1 million votes. We know, without any doubt, that the turnout of the recent election was manipulated, the company Smartmetrics said in a statement. As far as the Venezuelan constitution is concerned, what Juan did was completely legal. Here's a quotation from Article 233 of the Venezuelan constitution. The President of the Republic shall permanently unavailable to serve by reason of any of the following events: death, resignation, removal from office by decision of the Supreme Tribunal of Justice, permanent physical or mental disability certified by a medical board designated by the Supreme Tribunal of Justice with the approval of the National Assembly, abandonment of his position duly declared by the National Assembly, and recall by popular vote. When an elected president becomes permanently unavailable to serve prior to his inauguration, a new election by universal suffrage and direct ballot shall be held within 30 days. Pending election and inauguration of the new president, the president of the National Assembly shall take charge of the presidency of the republic. Let's translate this in plain English. Basically, Maduro cheated by 1 million votes. Juan is part of the National Assembly, and so therefore, what he did right now in Venezuela is perfectly legal by their constitution. A coup, by definition, is a violent and illegal seizure of power from a government. Basically, by definition, what the United States is doing is not a coup d'etat, and the main reason I say that is because the United States does not have any plans to overthrow the government. If they have plans to overthrow the government, they'll basically say, let's overthrow the government. What the United States is doing is merely supporting a person that has fallen the Constitution and actually is legitimate for presidency. What Juan did is completely legal. It's not a violent takeover, it's not illegal, it's not led by the United States. So how the hell, by definition, is this a coup d'etat?
It's pretty amazing that the same country that spent 2 years screaming about alleged Russian election meddling in 2016 is now applauding US meddling in Venezuela. But if you're watching US corporate news media, you would have no idea the US is meddling. They label Maduro a dictator and insist that all Venezuelans support the people that the US wants in power.
Maduro dictatorship, a dictator with no legitimate claim to power.
It has been a disaster on all counts.
What they leave out is that there are millions of people in Venezuela who voted for and support Maduro's government.
Aquí está el pueblo de Venezuela, aquí está el pueblo de Caracas, marchando en defensa de la revolución, en defensa de la democracia, no a la intervención imperialista.
Que nadie votó por esa persona. Nadie votó. Yo voté por Maduro. Mi voto es por Maduro.
But these people have been made invisible by an American corporate media that's been giddy over the prospect of a right-wing takeover of Venezuela for decades.
First and foremost, the party that Juan is a part of is not right-wing. The party that he's a part of is actually left-wing. How can you sit here and say that he's part of the right-wing without any evidence for that? Number two, Maduro is a dictator. There's no ifs, ands, or buts about this. You could be a liberal, you could be a socialist, and still acknowledge that Maduro starve his people to death, does not allow free speech, does not allow the free press. Basically, Maduro is an evil freaking guy. Also, how can you just sit there and say that Venezuelans support Maduro when Venezuelans moved to Peru, moved to Colombia, and other parts of South America to be in their new homes? Many of those Venezuelans are going to those other countries because they're persecuted, not to mention their vote was heavily altered, and so no, the majority of Venezuelans do not support Maduro. Majority of Venezuelans are against Maduro.
But these people have been made invisible by an American corporate media that's been giddy over the prospect of a right-wing takeover of Venezuela for decades. So much so that they recognize the legitimacy of a dude who just up and declared himself president, and are calling that democracy.
But Juan is not some random guy. Juan is part of the National Assembly. Underneath the Venezuelan Constitution, he has the right to declare himself to be a president because the votes for Maduro was illegitimate because he cheated by 1 million votes. Also, I find it hilarious that you said the stuff that Juan is doing is not democratic, yet you did not say the exact same thing for Maduro. Maduro is not following the Constitution, he is not respecting the Constitution, he's oppressing his people, yet you mean to tell me that the stuff that Juan is doing is undemocratic. That's just rich. Anyway guys, I'm about done with this video. It's like 5 more minutes of this nonsense, and personally, I cannot take it. I consider myself a liberal on most social issues, and personally, it just disgusts me that there are people on the left that are actually apologizing for Maduro, when in reality, they should not apologize for any dictator.